Hello, this is Cool Robots and Stuff. In this video, I want to explain the Mini-Me project, what I have done so far, and what are the plans for the future. Because I originally started this channel to host videos from my Arduino page, I didn't expect people to find it on YouTube, so there isn't much information about any of the videos. Mini-Me is my main project right now. It's a multi-purpose mini-humanoid robot. My main objective is to be able to control it remotely with an exoskeleton, but I also want to be able to control it with my computer and my phone, and implement autonomous movement and object recognition, among other things, all that while keeping it as cheap as possible to make. I decided to make it only from the torso up and use wheels or threads instead of legs, because legs are very complicated and very unreliable, as even commercial-legged humanoid robots are pretty unstable, and I wanted to be able to perform somewhat useful tasks that involve carrying objects or somehow shifting its center of mass, and I wanted to be able to move precisely using inverse kinematics. I started by making the first prototype with some scrap materials to test the strength of the servos, and I included some parts of the LEGO Mindstorms robotic kit that I ended up removing later. The second version had some big design improvements and was made using laser cut NDF and an Arduino Mega. The problem with this design was that I used very small servos for the arms without doing the math, and it could barely move its shoulder. After that, I decided to make a small robotic arm to evaluate different servo configurations. It worked well, so I decided to continue with the main robot. I simplified the arm design to have 3 degrees of freedom instead of 4 like a human arm. I changed the MDF for balsa wood, and with that I could finally get it to work without discarding the rest of the body. It still couldn't lift much weight though. After this, I made a small puppeteering rig out of balsa wood and some potentiometers to control it in a similar way to an exoskeleton. Then I moved on to make the first prototype of the real exoskeleton out of cardboard, all micro shells and potentiometers, and use a long cable to connect it with the robot. It worked okay, but there was some jitter and it wasn't very reliable. Around this time, I got a 3D printer and was finally able to make precise complex parts from my home. I redesigned the arms to use better servos. That improved things a lot, but it was very hard to test due to the wires getting very messy in the small space inside the torso, and proved my original arrangement of electronics very inefficient. I also finished a second version of the exoskeleton made of balsa wood, cardboard and 3D printed parts, but the cheap potentiometers sometimes stopped working, and when they did, they weren't doing so very reliably. That plus the messiness and unreliability of the robot prevented me from testing it. I moved on to paint the robot. I also designed some combat gear for it and 3D printed it, mostly for fun. Up to this point, the programming was very simple and ran exclusively in the Arduino. To make it a bit more intelligent, I decided to change the head for a phone. To test this idea, I made an object tracking device with my phone, 3D printed parts, servos and an Arduino connected with my computer. The programming was done in Python with the OpenCV library. After that, I was inactive for some time because I was participating in a team for an online robotics competition, which we won by the way, but I still managed to make some parts for power distribution and cable management, some research in different topics related to Mini-Me, and generally learned a lot along the way. That leads me to the present and where I'm working on right now. I made a concept for a new bigger 3D printed design and started thinking of making a simple server for online remote control, but then I realized I bit more than I can chew. I've decided that the next step is to get one arm working and the wiring organized in the robot that I already have. If my calculations are correct, it can already lift a bit less than half a kilo. Then establish communication with my computer through Bluetooth or serial to be able to work in Python. After that, I'll try to get the wheels working, then introduce the cell phone to get its sensor data, then get the other arm and the head working, and so on. Slowly getting to the more complex stuff like online control through a server and the exoskeleton. Other changes I would like to make along the way are changing the wheels for threads, making gearboxes for the motors, and replace some parts made out of wood and cardboard for 3D printed ones, both in the robot and in the exoskeleton. Progress is going to be slow, because as of now, I'm just one person working on Minimi, and I will continue participating in the next round of the robotics competition, but I'll try to continue working on this as much as possible and keep you updated, maybe in the form of pebbles. If you are interested in this project, consider subscribing to see future updates. If you have any questions about the project, leave them in the comments section. I'll read and reply to all the comments. For more frequent updates, you can check out my Instagram. A more detailed but slower documentation can be found in my Arduino page, and all the designs are in my Tinkercad. All links in the description.